There's a new push to free a Missouri grandmother from prison. This is Patty Pruitt. She's been in prison for 36 years for a murder she swears she did not commit.
Several lawmakers questioned the wisdom of keeping her there. They say she's not a threat to public safety, and your tax dollars could be better spent.
Here is our investigative reporter, Angie Ricono, with a report you will only see on KCTV 5. Patty has spent more time in prison than any other woman in Missouri. She's now 72, has 14 grandkids, and soon she'll have her first biological great-grandchild. She has high blood pressure, a tremor, and brittle bones. Tonight, you'll hear about her case and what she wants Governor Parson to know.
Please listen to our story. Listen to our story. Please.
Bill and Patty Pruitt were high school sweethearts who married on Valentine's Day. They had children. Patty admits the marriage wasn't perfect and the couple separated at times. She had affairs, but they patched things up, and on February 18, 1984, Bill and Patty were back together and living in this farmhouse in Holden, Missouri. It was storming when Bill Pruitt was shot and killed in his sleep. Patty says she was attacked too.
He said he was going to slit my throat if I didn't cooperate.
This is her original interview with police.
I remember I thought I heard lightning. It was a gunshot. And I think it was two of them.
She grabbed the kids and drove to a nearby farmhouse for help. The phone lines were cut at her house and the power was shut off.
I just kept trying to get them to understand they needed to find who came in and killed Bill. And nobody was paying any attention.
Patty was instantly the prime suspect. The murder weapon was found in the pond. Patty's boot prints were nearby. Investigators also snapped a photo of Patty's books. She read Hitchcock. But even worse, she had affairs. It was considered motive at trial.
If you're sitting in front of a jury thinks you're guilty. It's psychology.
The prosecutor mocked her claim that she was attacked, saying that in total darkness, he advanced with his murderous manner to enjoy Mrs. Pruitt's oft-enjoyed sexual favors. And he appealed to the jury to find her guilty. The dignity of the institution of marriage and the state and our community requires it.
They had made me out to be the worst Jezebel that ever lived.
A jury found Patty Pruitt guilty and sentenced her to life without the possibility of parole for 50 years. Newer legislation now allows people to be paroled after 30 years. But that wasn't the case in the 80s. Patty Pruitt is under those rules.
Standing in the front hallway looking up the steps going upstairs.
She's serving time in a case that is now criticized for being sloppy and sexist and possibly wrong.
Into the parents' bedroom.
Lawyers have fought for decades to prove Patty is innocent.
Shell Casey.
They lost in court to have old evidence tested for DNA. Patty says she was raped that night, but she didn't tell police or testify to that at trial.
He didn't rape me, I know that.
Did he ever attempt a penetration?
I said, what happened? And she said, he really hurt me.
Her daughter Jane backs her. She says she saw the evidence just days after the murder.
Bruises all through her inner thighs, just bad. From her hips down to her knees, just bruised, horrible bruises. And when I, as a grown up, I know that those were like, you know, bone on bone, knee, yeah.
All of Bill and Patty's children believe their mother is innocent. Two children told investigators someone else was in the house that night. A neighbor says there was a white sedan with a man inside watching Bill and Patty's house that night. The jury never heard that. And the jury never heard that the medical examiner originally believed this was a case of suicide.
Now, if I was smart, I would have gone, But no, I'm an idiot. So I said, what makes him think that?
Patty convinced her lawyer and investigators it was murder.
I said, he didn't shoot himself. That doesn't even make sense.
Patty never took a deal and has always maintained her innocence. She's now begging
for mercy.
What would you say to the governor? Why clemency?
Why not? I wrote him once and I said, what is preventing you from granting me clemency? Because I am no risk. So you can't say you're scared that I'm going to go out there and kill somebody.
Patty asked these questions to the governor in her weekly letters. It's a one-way conversation. Governor Parson is a former sheriff. In one letter, Patty points out her hands tested negative for gunpowder just hours after the murder. She also sends poetry. Hopes like dreams catch on the razor wire and never get out. Birds get out, others get out, I never get out. Another letter focuses on price, more than $88 a day, which tallies to $32,000 per year on average, to keep someone behind bars. She points out the elderly are even more expensive. It's true, Patty has all sorts of medical conditions.
High blood pressure.
She wears glasses, has a tremor, needs extensive dental work, and her bones are brittle. Taxpayers foot the bill.
Can you possibly find it in your heart to free me?
Patty has had hope. Governor Carnahan reviewed her case, but he tragically died in a plane crash. Governor Greitens' legal team quietly met with Patty's lawyers.
I am not perfect.
But he left office in disgrace. And then a push from lawmakers. More than 50 of them called for Patty's release.
A chance?
She had hope. Nothing happened. Lawmakers recently followed up with another letter to Governor Parson questioning, is it prudent for the state to continue to spend hundreds of thousands of taxpayer dollars to keep Patty Pruitt locked up for years to come?
Because part of me keeps thinking something will happen and I'll get out. I won't buy a bottle of Pantene until the last minute because I would hate to buy it and then be freed. Now, see, that's the insanity in me.
Hope can be cruel. It can also last half a lifetime. In Patty's case, it's 36 years and counting.
You grow older and older and more feeble, and nothing ever changes. And then you think, am I going to die in here? Are they going to call my kids someday and want to know where to ship the body?
We reached out to Governor Parson for a response. He has been granting clemency and pardons to others, mostly in old drug cases. His spokesperson says he has made progress with the clemency backlog. There were more than 3,000 petitions. It's now down to around 2,000. Patty's clemency petition has never officially been answered. It's more than 12 years old. Angie Ricono, KCTV 5 News.